Trying to enhance blockchain networks is a work in progress since the technology is still considered in its infancy. Creating a decentralized system does present its challenges, specifically while trying to protect it from being taken advantage of. When Bitcoin was launched, introducing the technology, it started with a proof-of-work or POW mechanism. Its main function was achieving consensus for the blockchain. In POW, this is achieved by having one participant write the next block in a blockchain, otherwise known as mining, which earned them rewards in crypto. But with the many issues that mining presented in terms of energy and computing power consumption, the proof-of-stake mechanism came to be. Blockchains like Polkadot, Cardano, Avalanche were created as POS blockchains. POS differs from POW in that it uses validators to validate the transactions on the blockchain, a step to improve the flaws of POW. Network validators stake their crypto and earn in return rewards. Since this usually needs a large investment, many exchanges have resorted to taking it upon themselves to do so. More recently, a new blockchain consensus protocol has been created, Delegated Proof of Stake, or DPOS. Stick around as we go over how the newest consensus mechanism works, have an overview of its pros and cons, and check which blockchains are now using it. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. How does DPOS work? Let's dive deeper into how the consensus algorithm works to further explain how DPOS functions and why it is considered to be the most effective among its competitors. The decentralization of blockchain networks needs the verification of every transaction made, which is usually done through a certain algorithm that would ensure which transactions are valid from the ones that are not. This is what the blockchain consensus is. After trying the proof of work and the proof of stake, the delegated proof of stake has been introduced. It mainly functions just like the proof of stake does, with a major difference. As previously mentioned, users themselves need to stake their coins to participate in POS, which is the same case for DPOS consensus. However, those users staking coins on a DPOS blockchain need to elect delegates who are the only ones that can validate the transactions. So all other users technically pool their coins in the centralized staking pool and vote for delegates, which are also referred to as witnesses or block producers. The user's coins will be linked to the delegate who they voted for, but they will remain physically in the user's wallet. Once all delegates are elected, they must together verify each transaction and decide which ones are approved and which ones are to be rejected. This mechanism is the best one among all three consensus mechanisms, as it solves most of the limitations of both POW and POS. Now that we know how DPOS mainly works, let us go over a few of its advantages as well as its disadvantages. Pros. 1. Scalability. Many emerging applications need a high level of scalability, and DPOS provides a faster process for transactions than what POW or POS offer. 2. Energy efficient. Much like what POS offered in terms of way less energy consumption than POW spends, DPOS also consumes much less energy. 3. Everyone benefits. Every user can get rewards when voting for delegates. No one needs to put in a large investment like in POS to take part or benefit. 4. Any hardware will do. Participants of a DPOS do not need to have expensive and specialized computers to take part. 5. Voting system. All voting is done in real time, so any malicious action can be immediately detected. 6. Democratic system. A delegate who isn't performing well can simply be voted out and potentially lose their income as well as their reputation. With many advantages of DPOS, one might think that there is no downside, but there is actually. Some of the cons of DPOS are: cons. 1. An attack can be organized. With fewer people put in charge as delegates, a few votes can turn the tables, making the system vulnerable. 2. The more tokens you have, the more you earn. Obviously, the biggest influencers and the ones that gain the most rewards are the ones who have the most tokens. 3. Fear of centralization. When the decision lies among a few people, it is easy for the delegates to organize themselves and keep the validation amongst them, which would eventually make the whole mechanism less decentralized. 4. The need for a large number of users. The success of the blockchain consensus relies on people's participation. If that isn't available, then DPOS will not function as it originally intends to do. Who uses DPOS? A few of the major blockchains using DPOS are the EOS network, Tron, and the Cosmos network. Elastos and Terra Luna are both examples of coins that also rely on the DPOS system. We are witnessing the rapid evolution of a new technology, and every addition or modification made brings us a step forward towards a decentralized world. Let us know what you think of DPOS and where you believe it needs improvement. Hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel to see you in the next one.